Adoration at the very holy sight of our heavenly mother, who is revered as Hariyar Mata. We are in the presence of Jesus. Jesus is the living God. He is in the Holy Eucharist, and as we are celebrating the feast of Corpus Christi, the Latin title of the feast, which is translated into English as the most precious body and blood of Jesus Christ. In fact, the feast of the Eucharist. My dear friends, we are in a very special situation. Most of us, we are staying at home and participating in the adoration. The adoration is coming to you from the Basilica of Our Lady of Health, Harihar, Karnataka, India. Our Heavenly Mother is interceding for us. We will have the same experience of the Apostles as we are participating in this adoration, the special Eucharistic adoration. in the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, verse 14, we visualize the beautiful scene of our Heavenly Mother encouraging the apostles, staying with them, being with them, and praying for them. If you observe the miraculous statue of Our Lady of Health, Harihar, we can very well see the Heavenly Mother, who is folding her hands and praying for us. We offer to her intercession. It was through her prayers Jesus had sent his promised Spirit upon the apostles. We will ask the same Mother to pray for us as we are celebrating the feast of Corpus Christi. As we revere, adore the Eucharistic Lord, we need to remember the words of Jesus, which is written in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, verse 20. I will remain with you always. Let us pray to the Lord to send the same Holy Spirit upon us. As we sing the hymn to the Holy Spirit, let the Holy Spirit come upon us to make us, to mold us, to be with us. My dear friends, at this situation, at this pandemic where the sickness is playing havoc, we remember and pray for all the victims. May the power of the Holy Spirit be with us, guide us, encourage us, and make us to realize the strength of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. With same devotion and dedication of the apostles and our Heavenly Mother, let us extend our hands and sing the song to the Holy Spirit. the Holy Spirit confirms God's presence in us. The Holy Spirit has really strengthened us. The Holy Spirit will guide us. He will always make us, mold us. As we are praying to the strength from the Holy Spirit, let us remember the words of Jesus in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 14. Jesus gives the assurance, I will not leave you orphaned. Mean to say, how many in this world today are placed in the containment zone due to the sickness COVID-19? How many of them are quarantined, suffering, and feeling lonely? The assurance of Jesus should fill the minds and hearts. I will not leave you orphaned. My dear friends, as we are participating in this Eucharistic adoration, let us remember, Lord Jesus will stay with us. Strengthen us through the gift of the Holy Spirit. Encourages us. The gift of the Spirit has filled our heart. Through the gift of the Spirit, we have become God's children. As we are the real children of God, we need to thank Him for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We want to be with you forever. Your presence in the Holy Eucharist is encouraging. Your presence in the Holy Spirit has made us to realize that the Spirit doesn't make us timid. As St. Paul telling to Timothy, when Timothy went and approached St. Paul, he said to him, the Lord will not give us the spirit that is timid. The Lord will give us the spirit of truth, courage. And the Spirit is a solace who remains in our heart. With this strength, all of us are able to call Jesus as our friend. What a friend we have in Jesus. He will take all our pains, all our difficulties, all our preoccupations. Jesus is our true friend. So we thank the Lord for this great gift, for His presence in the Eucharist, and sing the hymn, what a friend we have in Jesus. He will take all our pains and all our difficulties. Let us with all humility sing this hymn, what a friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer.
We have a great friend whose name is Jesus of Nazareth. He lived here on earth 2000 years ago. He is very much alive and active in the Eucharist. Let us thank the Lord for the great gift of the Eucharist as we are celebrating the feast of Corpus Domini, the feast of the most holy body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord. We praise you. We adore you as we feel the presence of you in this holy bread. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Especially as we are having this adoration at the shrine basilica of Our Lady of Health, Harihar, the place which is situated in the central part of Karnataka, India. Thousands and thousands come and visit the shrine during the ordinary days. Lakhs together participate the feast on 7th and 8th September, all because we have our Heavenly Mother who is interceding for us as Harihar Mata, Our Lady of Health, Harihar. We thank the Lord for this great gift. And as we are concluding this adoration, we will remember that the Lord, who is present in the Eucharist, will guide us. He has told in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 7, ask and you will receive. We are asking for the great gifts through the great intercession of Our Lady of Health, Harihar. May the Eucharistic Lord be benevolent on all the nations of the world, as the world is suffering from the pandemic COVID-19. Let the coronavirus run away from this world so that we can have a healthy society. Thank you, Jesus, for this great gift. As we are adoring you, may the blessing spread throughout the world. As we conclude this adoration, we need your blessings. We need your graces. That beautiful hymn, which is written in Latin, we are going to sing now, is composed by a very great saint, Thomas Aquinas, as ordered by the Pope himself. Please compose a hymn for the feast of Corpus Christi. Remember this saint also today. As we sing the song, sing the hymn, let us thank the Lord for his presence in the Holy Eucharist. We were not able to take up a procession, but doesn't matter. The Lord will heal us and touch us in the same way. During the Eucharist, we are not able to receive the Holy Communion. Most of us, those who are above 65 years, those who are below 10 years, are not able to visit the church. For them, that they should run and come one day when the pandemic disappears totally from this earth. It is going to happen because we have a healer in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this great gift. Thank you, Lord, for this great gift in the Eucharist. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We adore you in the most precious body and blood of you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers. Thank you, Lord, for giving Our Lady of Good Health to this shrine basilica of Harihar. In silence, now let us prepare ourselves to receive the blessings by singing the hymn Tantum Ergo Sacramentum. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. Who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Now, let us receive the blessing on this great feast of Corpus Domini, Corpus Christi, the most precious body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. As we commemorate the feast of the Eucharist, let us receive the special blessings from the Basilica of Our Lady of Health, Harihar.
ಬೇಡಿ ಬಂದ ಭಕ್ತರಿಗೆ ಆಸರೆ ನೀವು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಿಸುವ